What does this remind you of? Neeraj Chopra? Yes, the only track and field athlete of India who has won a gold medal after a long wait of 100 years. And what does it have to do with insulin resistance, our topic today? A lot it has to do. My first question to you is, I want you to think of why in India we win so few Olympic medals. Is there a reason for that? Think over it. Why are smaller countries like Italy and France and Britain, of course, US, China, Japan are way ahead, why are they earning more Olympic medals? And as you reflect on that question, I want you to think of a parallel question, and that is, why are there so many diabetics in this country? Why are there so many blood pressure and high cholesterol and overweight people in this country? And is there some connection between them? And what I've found is there's a very deep connection, and the connection goes into every family. How the family thinks, how the family feels, how the family acts. So the problem, as I feel, is in India, what exactly is exercise, what exactly is regular activity, is not completely clear in every family. For example, people feel walking for 45 minutes is a great exercise, but actually it's a normal human activity. By walking or by doing just yoga, we've not created Olympic athletes. Similarly, when it comes to diabetes and all lifestyle disorders, the knowledge that is needed in every family of why these disorders happen is not clear. So, simple point, if in every family, in our community, if it's not clear what is real exercise, what is deep nutrition, which can win Olympic medals, we are going to have fewer medals. And the same holds good. If in every family, the reason, the deep-rooted reason why insulin resistance exists is not clear. I repeat the word, insulin resistance is not clear. We will be continuing to have diabetes, BP, cholesterol, thyroid, PCOD, heart attacks, strokes, snoring, joint pains, acidity, and all kinds of health problems. So, it's very important that through this video, we reach every family and every family gets a feel of what insulin resistance is. And before we come to insulin resistance, it's important to understand insulin a little bit, which many of us know. It's a beautiful, powerful, interesting, wonderful hormone coming from the pancreas. Its job is to pull the glucose into the cells. And as it's trying to pull the glucose into the cells away from the blood, it's actually using a lock and key mechanism. So insulin is like a key attaching to a lock, opening the lock and pulling the glucose in. Along with the glucose, it's pulling in fat and also water. It's a growth hormone, it's helping your body grow. And as this lock and key mechanism gets into a problem, then the glucose cannot go in. And if the glucose cannot go in, you will be secreting more insulin. And as you secrete more insulin, you will hold back more water, more fat, more glucose, and attract all kinds of lifestyle disorders, including overweight, diabetes, BP, cholesterol, etc. So sum and substance, every family needs to get in touch with the lock and key mechanism and need to make it work properly. And the best way to learn about it is to know all the seven reasons for insulin resistance. There are seven reasons for insulin resistance, out of which four are linked to diet, two are linked to exercise, and one is linked to stress. It's very difficult to cover all four reasons at one go. So what I'm going to focus on is the most important exercise-related reason, which most of us don't know. And that reason is called stagnated lymph. or stuck up blood. And you may wonder what that is. What is that? Stagnated lymph, stuck up blood. So keeping this very simple, from the heart we are pumping beautiful oxygenated nutritious blood throughout the body through the arteries, and the veins are pulling back that blood into the heart. Arteries have the benefit of the heart pressure. Veins have the benefit of the valves inside them. Both of them work together to throw the oxygenated blood out and pull the deoxygenated blood in. Now comes the important point. Veins can pull back only 90% the blood, not the glucose, the blood which has gone away. And remaining 10% of the blood cannot be pulled back by veins. They need the help of a specialized blood vessel called as lymphatic capillaries, lymph vessels. And that's one network throughout the body which works in great synchronicity and pulls the stuck up blood back to the heart for its purification. Now comes a very simple example to connect with. If this stuck up blood, which is stagnated lymph, not fully functional, then the way water gets stuck up outside the body and creates problems in terms of attracting dirt and plastic and mosquitoes and algae and becomes a nuisance for the entire society. Similarly, stuck up blood or stagnated lymph, that 10% blood, if it gets stuck around your neck, into your back, to the base of the spine, in your trunk, around your hips, in your thighs, anywhere across the body, it is going to create nuisance. And you must take special efforts to move this stuck up blood. You may be walking, and walking is a great activity, not the greatest exercise though. When you walk, your calves will kind of compress, your thighs will move to a certain degree, and the stuck up blood from your feet will come back to the heart. But the stuck up blood of your trunk, along your spine, where there are so many muscles and fat, it's not going to come back. And if it doesn't come back, this stuck up blood is going to create an inflammation in the lock and key, where insulin is trying to attach to the lock and open up the lock. It will not be able to open it up quickly because that entire area has got swollen up. So what to do? Do the right exercises which will help you to move the stuck up blood, and two of them which are there on our YouTube videos, you must visit them. First one is the world's best warm up, where you rub the hand, you play with the joints, you shake the muscles and you beat up the body. World's best warm up for the whole body, you move the stuck up blood back to the heart. And second very important exercise is chair Surya Namaskara. I'm sitting on chair for the same reason. Do Namaskara, you go back, you go down, you lift up one leg, the other leg, and there's a beautiful sequence, again available on YouTube FMD channel, for you to understand what it is to move the stuck up blood of your hip joint, of your spine, of your trunk, when you bend forward and backward. And that movement of the 10% stuck up blood will reduce the acid inflammation, which is creating insulin resistance, which is creating diabetes, BP, cholesterol, COPD, thyroid, heart attack, stroke, snoring, acidity, acanthosis, and many other problems. And if you're interested to learn more about the remaining six causes, do join our online first session, in which over 2.5 hours, followed by almost 1.5 to 2 hours of question answers, we teach you in detail all the causes of insulin resistance and the way you can overcome it on your own with our help, step by step, and become free of diabetes and many lifestyle disorders. So may every family understand, stand under what is insulin resistance, and may every family understand what is correct exercise. May we churn out many more Olympians, and may we reduce the number of diabetics in this country. Thank you for watching us, and be in touch. Bye-bye.